the BJP is very concerned about the state of affairs and the condition of the Indian students who, for no fault of theirs, had enrolled in a university which apparently is not registered by law in the US. We reiterate that it is not the students' fault, and these students pay their fees, they are self-financed with proper legal documents which are required to visit or study in the US. The Ministry of External Affairs will have to be more assertive in making sure that the students are not denied justice in any way. But while saying this, we already feel that the students have been put to absolute inhuman treatment. They are not cattle in a ranch to be given an electronic gadget, to be collared and to be monitored every minute of their stay there after being legal visitors violates their human and fundamental rights. We condemn this. The US government should understand that these students have, after all, gone there with their visa duly obtained. And if the university is illegal, it was for them to have sorted the matter out. It's no fault of the students. We demand that the government of India take a far more proactive role to ensure that these students are absolutely safe and not treated in a way in which they are violative of their fundamental rights. The government should assert its right and make sure that the US government gives them access to proper judicial process and ensure that these students are given an option of wanting to further pursue or come back. First, it was Australia, where Indian students were ill-treated. The government was giving only a delayed response, the government of India. Now again, only because there's so much pressure because of the media and the students' own parents in this country, the government of India seems to be taking steps which are not adequate to meet the demands in which they have to be met with. The students are in a very, very uncertain, insecure environment. To be collared is not at all a pleasant thing. In fact, it is degrading. We demand that the government, through the Ministry of External Affairs, take immediate action and proactive action. Thank you.
Ma'am, in Hindi, and then Karmapa also.
Karmapa mein koi dabai nahi chuke hain. भारत देश से जो स्टूडेंट्स अमेरिका गए हैं उनके अपने हायर एजुकेशन परस्यू करने के लिए, उनके हालत अभी बहुत ही गंभीर परिस्थिति में है। जैसे गाय बेंस को अमेरिका में एक गैजेट कॉलर में डाला जाता है जिससे वो कहाँ जाते हैं, कहाँ रहते हैं, इसको मॉनिटर कर सकते हैं। ऐसे एक कॉलर पहनने के लिए आवश्यकता आ गई। ये गैर कानूनी है, इनह्यूमन है और उनके बेसिक अधिकार के खिलाफ है। भारतीय जनता पार्टी इसको पूरे कंडन करती है और हमारी सरकार यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स से प्रोएक्टिव तरीके से उनके अपने बातों रखना चाहिए जिससे तुरंत वो स्टूडेंट्स को इस पद्धति से मॉनिटर करने के लिए रिहा हो सकते हैं। ये विद्यार्थी जो गए हैं वो उनके अपने पैसा भरकर यूनिवर्सिटी में भर्ती कर रहे और उनके वीसा भी पूरे वैलिड डॉक्यूमेंट्स के साथ गए। अगर यूनिवर्सिटी रजिस्टर्ड नहीं है, वो गलती स्टूडेंट्स का नहीं है, अमेरिकन अथॉरिटीज़ का है। इसीलिए भारत देश विदेश मंत्रालय तुरंत इसमें बहुत ज़्यादा कार्रवाई उठाना चाहिए, जिससे लीगल राइट्स मिलता है स्टूडेंट्स को और उनको कम से कम एक ऑप्शन मिलना चाहिए कि क्या वो दूसरे यूनिवर्सिटी में पढ़ेंगे या तो वापस आएंगे। इसमें तुरंत कार्रवाई होना चाहिए। पहले ऑस्ट्रेलिया में हो रहे थे ऐसे, अभी अमेरिका में हो रही है। भारत सरकार के विदेश मंत्रालय रेस्पॉन्सिव तरीके से आगे बढ़ना चाहिए और तुरंत ऐसे सख्त कदम उठाना जिससे स्टूडेंट्स का हालत बेहतर हो और उनके राइट्स में उल्लंघन ना हो। उसका डेट अभी तय नहीं हुआ है। सुषमा जी जाएगी सुप्रीम कोर्ट में।
आज वहाँ पर पूरा इंक्वायरी हुआ है, उसे पूछताछ हुई है और जो फोर्सेज वहाँ गई थी पूछताछ कर, उनका कहना है कि वो सेटिस्फाइड नहीं है और पूरी तरह से इंडिकेशन है कि स्पायरिंग जो है वो चाइनीज गवर्नमेंट के साथ इनका कुछ ना कुछ रहा है। क्या रिएक्शन है?
ये बहुत ही सेंसिटिव मामला है। अभी कम से कम 5 सरकार की डिपार्टमेंट, एनफोर्समेंट डायरेक्ट्रेट है, फिनांस मिनिस्ट्री के 2-3 इन्वेस्टिगेटिव एजेंसी है, रॉ है, सब इसमें इन्वेस्टिगेट कर रहे हैं और इतने कैश उनके पास मिल चुके हैं, इससे क्या मतलब निकालना चाहिए, इसे तो इसके ऊपर बहुत ही गहरी इन्वेस्टिगेशन होना है। उसके बाद हम भी हमारी टिप्पणी रखेंगे। अभी तो देख रहे हैं कि इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसी इसके ऊपर उनके अपने राय क्या पहले रखने वाले हैं। The raids in the Sikkim monastery of Karmapa, who had about a decade or more ago fled from China and come to India and claimed that he was the monastic head of the Karmapa sect, have revealed a lot of foreign currency. As it is, there are more than 5 government agencies which are investigating and raiding to find out what is going on. At this stage, the Bharatiya Janata Party shall wait for the findings which come out of these raids and we shall respond subsequently. It's a very sensitive matter and I think we'll wait for the full details to come. It's certainly not appropriate. It is certainly not appropriate for that matter for him to continue to leave alone dealing with the CBI on 2G related matters. The CVC should quit immediately.
Madam Vistaj, ma'am, camera.
On attack against Indian communication man by BJP. Does the BJP think that this action of Indian government is sufficient, or in what way does the BJP express its concern in this matter? Not by the way of statement, by meeting the affected Tamil.
Our President Sri Nitin Gadkari was in Chennai. The question relates to the situation of Indian fishermen in Sri Lanka-India borders. We have announced, in fact, the President has announced that Sushma ji would be going over to Vedaranyam to meet up with the families of the affected fishermen. We shall also be pursuing it through the Ministry of External Affairs with the Sri Lankan government to find out how best this can have a long-term solution, because now it is about 2 fishermen. This has been repeatedly happening. We should ensure that due to a certain kind of situation in maritime waters in that area, whether it is around Kachathivu or otherwise, our fishermen cannot be put to difficulty. Life-threatening incidents cannot happen. Repeatedly we have violations by the Sri Lankan army in suspending and arresting the fishermen who go there. Therefore, we will definitely be taking action. One step which was already announced, although the date has not been given, is that Leader of Opposition, Lok Sabha, Srimati Sushma Swaraj, will be going over to Tamil Nadu to meet up with the families of the affected fishermen.
In Kerala, there is a controversy regarding
Well, this case has been lingering in Kerala for a very long time. It has come up again. Certainly, It has a lot of questions which have to be answered by the current government, and certainly some questions which the Congress also will have to face. It reveals the true face of the kind of politics which is being played there, and it certainly is going to become an issue during the forthcoming elections.
Thank you.